a better feel for the fight and can take it where they want. John McGinnis, the referee, Vester Harris in the blue, Foster Eberly in the red as we get ready for this heavyweight bout.
I'm very excited to see what game plan Foster imposes in this fight.
Same. Especially now with the change of heavyweight just this morning.
As Vester looks like he's the shorter athlete. Harder sometimes to get under those guys and lift them for takedowns about that lower center of gravity.
And I mentioned the wrestling, and you're going to see Vester go for it right away. He went straight for the takedowns, but Foster did a good job at getting him against the cage.
Yeah, great balance. He was almost down there, kept a good base, and now he's in control in the clinch against the fence. Excellent body lock takedown for Foster, and he goes straight into full guard.
When you're a heavyweight fighter, you never want to be the guy on bottom. Big strikes coming from Foster Eberly.
Doing a good job. He's trying to tie up one of the wrists to make him a little more defenseless as he's throwing his ground and pound. Excellent technique.
Vester going to stand back up to his feet.
Good head position here from Foster. Even though he is the taller guy, he's getting low.
Whoa. Wow, looks like Vester Harris got a little takedown there.
He benefited from being the lower man there, just kind of dropped his weight and sent Foster in a throw over top of him.
What a trip by Foster Eberly. He was perfectly set up, double underhooks, and went for the trip. And he goes right back to the side where he wants to be.
Yeah, he's in a dominant position in side control here. And with the fence there, it kind of limits what Foster can do to try to escape the position.
Good fight IQ by Foster Eberly. And, you know, we talk about how these guys have more fights, but just the way that he's able to take a position wherever he's at is good. It looks like he's putting it in.
It does look like he has the arm under the chin here.
He did let go. He's locked it back in. Maybe he's got it tighter now.
Well, he's trying to get a better angle.
A lot of pressure on the head.
He's got him flattened out here. Back mount. It looks like this might be the end.
Lester doing an okay job at defending, but he needs to get his head up. He needs to make movement. Foster's hips are high.
He did a good job of building back to a base, but he put himself in a worse position with the rear naked choke here. Foster choosing to strike his way out of position.
10 seconds left in the bout. Foster Eberly in the red. Vester comes out, throws a nice kick.
Looks like he threw that right off the glove touch. Foster back into another dominant position here.
Very nice job by Foster Eberly to stay composed and use his body weight, his momentum against him to get back on top.
It's a beautiful job, like you said, using that momentum, and ends up in mount. Very dominant position, and let's see if he can do what it takes here to finish this fight.
Oh, he's taking his back here. He's going to make sure he's adjusted his hips. And he's in his corner right now, too, which is where you want to be if you're Foster Eberly.
Absolutely. It really helps slow things down when you're able to hear your coaches in these grappling exchanges. It does seem like Fester must come from a wrestling background. He seems very more comfortable giving up his back than a lot of guys probably should. But he seems to be escaping the positions once he gets to that position, so he must be comfortable.
And this round, you see Fester doing a much, much better job at defending his head. And you see Foster trying to push his hands down. And maybe that's for a couple of reasons, but definitely a good job for Fester on defending those shots in that ground pound, because ultimately he almost got finished with it in the first round.
Yeah, he has yet to sustain any significant damage in this round, but is still getting controlled by Foster.
Fester able to get on top.
Fester had his posture a little too high and ultimately cost him the position.
Now looks like Vester's going to try to get a little ground and pound here.
Fester doing a good job of recovering full guard. He was in half guard there for a moment. And, with him being the longer guy, let's see if he can use those limbs to escape here and reverse the position.
Sure, and I mentioned Vester here is everybody he's lost to in his career was taller than him. I should also mention he has beat guys that are taller than him as well. So I should clarify there for Vester Harris.
Sure, it does seem like, what was his height, the five?
He's 5'8".
Yeah. Pretty short frame for 205 pounds, this fight being heavyweight now. So he's going to probably be the shorter guy in almost all of his fights.
Sure.
Unfortunately.
And this is a much tougher round to judge if you are a judge. And thank goodness we're not, Brandon. And it looked like Vester was a little more controlled in that round. And a little bit of trash talk happening. And they will start the third round with a glove touch, which is good to see after the little bit of controversy at the end of the second. And you've seen Vester come out with those low kicks. Wow.
Beautiful back kick thrown from Foster there.
He looks for the takedown, but he shoots with his head down. And in MMA, you don't always see people level change enough to get their takedowns. And it looked like that was the problem there for Vester.
Foster reverses a position. He is in control of the clinch here. And it seemed like Foster wanted to come out and use that that height and reach advantage of his in the striking department, but Fester did a good job of closing that distance once again.
I don't know if that was the smartest. Wow! And Foster's gonna tap him there.
Seemed to grab the choke simultaneously as he was getting the takedown, and very quick tap out from Fester. Seems to be in good spirits after suffering the defeat, but another very exciting fight from Foster Eberly.
Yeah, very impressive fight for Foster Eberly. He's going to move to 4-2. Get that fight at heavyweight. I'm sure he wants to come back down to light heavyweight where he cuts all that weight too. But it's always nice to get a nice win versus a veteran in the amateur place of Ohio.
Yeah, it was definitely an opponent with the most experience that he's fought, and I'm sure he's very happy with his performance.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee John McGinnis called a stop to the action at 53 seconds of the third round, declaring a winner by rear naked choke.